Hello. Here is how I make an album cover with a handmade 3D text in Chrome from zero. First, draw a title with a lettering you like. Take a picture of it or scan it and then import it into Illustrator. Select your image and in the top bar select Image Vectorization, and then click on the icon of a panel next to it. From here you will be able to create a vector shape by managing the level of detail of your shape. Just play with the parameters, threshold, strokes, angles, noise. Once we are satisfied with the menu bar, we will click on Decompose, which will create our vector shape. We will then remove the white part that was created during our vectorization. By selecting all our shapes and right-clicking on Simplify, we will be able to remove points from our cheeses, which will allow us to round them off easily. Then we will be able to touch up the topography manually by simply rounding the corners by selecting a shape and clicking and dragging the white circles that appear in the corners. When our visual is finished, we will transform it into a 3D shape. To do this, go to Effect, 3D and Materials, then Extrusions and Bevels. In the panel that opens, we will select Dilatation, then put our shape on its X, Y, Z axis at 0 degrees to see it from the front. Then we will choose our depth according to what we are looking for. But it is important to set the volume to 100% to keep a roundness. When it's okay for you, we're going to convert our shape into a 3D file for Blender. In the window, you're going to open the panel called File Export, and just click and drop your shape group in the panel. Make sure you select the OBJ export format for the manipulation to work. Then export. Open Blender. Delete the default cube and reposition your camera. In File, Import, choose Wavefont.obj, and find the place where you exported your Illustrator file. Once imported, reduce it and adjust it in your camera view. We'll add some metallic texture and reorient the light so that it illuminates our shape. Then we'll go to the Shading panel to get a better look at our render. At the top left of our panel, we will choose World and add nodes to modify the environment image of our 3D object. This is the image we will see reflected in our 3D shape. The nodes to add are the following: Textures Coordinate, Mapping, Image Texture, Hue Saturation, Bright, Contrast. You just have to link them together, and in the Image Texture node select the image you want. I will choose an image that I will find in my future visual for more coherence. Make sure you are in Viewport Render to have a precise view of your nodes by selecting the fourth icon on the top right of your 3D panel. Also remember to disable the visibility of your environment in the Render Properties panel. Film. Check the Transparent box. This will allow you to export your object with a transparent background. We will be able to play with the parameters of our nodes to move our environment in the direction we want and make it more or less stand out in the reflection of our metal object. Once satisfied, in Output Properties, select Color, RGBA, and File Format, PNG. Then in the render window at the top left, render image. Once the render is done, image, and save as. Import your 3D render in PNG format into Photoshop and create a square background that represents our album cover and then center it. We're going to import the same image we used for our 3D environment and put it in the background. With a mask, I cut my image to a square format and then I make it a dynamic object. I'm going to duplicate it and open my filter gallery to add a textured effect. Here I will play with halftone pattern, which gives a print effect to my image. Once validated in the color range selection, I will select the black of the image and hide the layer to remove the white. I will then make the slap of my image visible without any effects and play with the blending modes of my layer with a mask so that it integrates as I wish with my image. We'll then double-click on our Chrome text to open the slap style panel. Here we will add a drop shadow, an internal glow, and play with the bevel and stamp settings to make our text fit even better with our visual. Once we've done most of the work with our main elements, all that's left is to add the details of our visual. I'm going to import shapes directly from Illustrator and add them to my visual little by little. Once finished, we will add a plastic texture to our visual to make it more realistic. We will group all our layers and add our texture on top. Apply a clipping mask to it and then in its blend mode choose color density. To add a 3D effect to our cover, we can simply use the style panel to add a bevel and stamp effect directly to our group. Once finished, it's time to convert all this to a dynamic layer and apply a camera raw filter and finish rendering our image to our liking. Back to Blender and our 3D object. In our bottom animation tab, we are going to add different rotation keyframes to our object to make it a loop. To do this, we will change the values of the z-axis. I have chosen to give it a rotation of minus 20 degrees, and then click on the white dot to the right of our value field to apply a keyframe. A yellow dot will appear on the bottom of our timeline, indicating that the position of our object is taken into account. We will move to frame 40 and apply a value of plus 20 degrees. Then frame 80 a value of minus 20 degrees. This will put the object at the end of our timeline at the same position as at the beginning and create a loop. In output properties, set frame start to 1 and end to 80. This will be the number of PNGs that Blender will generate, i.e. 80 frames. All that remains is to choose an export folder and in render choose render animation. In parallel in Photoshop, we will flatten our layers to have a minimum. Here I will separate my texture effect layer and flatten the rest of the album cover. Because I intend to put the text between these two layers. All that's left is to save our Photoshop file as a PSD and open After Effects. Once in After Effects, we will first import our PSD by checking the Editable Layer Style box. This will generate a sequence with our two slaps. Then we will import our 80 frames of PNG from Blender. Just select them all and check the PNG sequence box. This will automatically compile our files and create an animation. All we have to do is add our sequence between the two slaps of the previous sequence. And to export our video. Now you know how to animate a topography in Chrome using Blender, your visual on Photoshop and After Effects. Don't forget to subscribe and like this video for more tutorials. Have a nice day.